Hello and welcome to our low-power DC-DC mini lab video series. In our online forum we get quite a few questions regarding the switch node voltage measurement on a step-down converter. The measurement could show some high overshoot or undershoot. This could be related to the measurement setup or to the PCB layout, both subjects we want to discuss in today's video. For the measurement, we want to use the TPS62097, a 2A step-down converter switching at 2.4 MHz. So let's start with the measurement and measure the switch node, overshoot and undershoot on this evaluation board. We connect the scope probe to the test point that is connected to the switch node of the DC-DC converter, and the ground clip we just connect to the nearest ground. So now let's have a look at the oscilloscope. So we see the switching waveform here. Let's zoom in to the rising and falling edge. We have 2 volt resolution, so we have roughly 2 volt overshoot and about 2 volt undershoot. Let's store this measurement so we can compare it with the improved measurement setup. In order to better understand the improved measurement setup, I will show you some slides. Here you see the circuit of the 62097. The first thing we do to improve the measurement setup is to connect the scope probe directly from the switch pin to the power ground pin. Then, instead of the normal scope probe, we want to use a low inductance probe technique where we remove the long ground clip and replace it by a ground spring. That way, we reduce the noise being picked up from the circuit. And of course, the scope tip we connect directly to the switch node of the circuit. So let's use the low inductance probe technique now. For that, I remove the hook tip and the ground clip of the scope probe. And I have prepared already an evaluation module using a ground spring. So the tip of the scope probe we connect to the test point that is connected to the switch node of the DC-DC converter. The ground spring is connected to the output capacitor power ground. Now let's have a look at the oscilloscope. The white trace shows the previous measurement setup. The yellow trace shows the setup with the low inductance probe technique. And we can see a reduction in overshoot of almost 2 volt, as well as a reduction in undershoot by about 1 volt. After the switch node voltage measurement, let's have a look at the PCB layout. Here you see the circuit of a standard step-down converter. To optimize the PCB layout, we need to identify any loops with high change in current. For a step-down converter, the output current is continuous. Therefore, those loops are uncritical. The input current is discontinuous with high change in current and high change in magnetic field. Therefore, any parasitic trace inductance will cause voltage shifts as well as voltage spikes. To minimize this effect, we need to minimize parasitic trace inductance by really making this input loop as small as possible. The most effective way to do this is to place the input capacitor directly from the input pin to the power ground pin of your circuit. So, for the PCB layout, the first thing what we need to do for a standard step-down converter is placing the input capacitor as close as possible from the input pin to the power ground pin. Therefore, you really minimize this loop and you minimize any parasitic trace inductance in this loop. As next step, we populate the remaining components of your PCB layout. And last but not least, we route our logic pins. We have shown an improved measurement setup as well as PCB layout techniques to minimize switch node voltage overshoot and undershoot. For more information, please go to ti.com where you find online forum as well as relevant application notes. Thanks for watching.